going, everybody? I'm Rob DeMello, and this is the season finale of Cover 2, Hawaii High School Football Weekly. After nearly 4 months of action, it all comes down to this. Coach Brian Tate will join us shortly as he and a handful of coaches, players, and analysts will get us ready for the HHSAA's championship night in both Division 1 and 2. Sam Spangler will get his red carpet on, handing out the inaugural Cover 2 Player Awards, and Kanoa Leahy goes one-on-one with the Coach of the Year. But first, let's take a look at how we got to title night on the quest for the Koa Trophy. And we start in Division 1, where numbers 1 and 2 followed through. Top-seeded Punahou beat Barrington Friday night 48-6, while Mililani put away Campbell 41-7 to set up the OIA and ILH for the 15th straight season. And over in Division 2, 1 and 2 are POW. Top-seeded Lahaina Luna beat by number 4 Kaiser 20-9 Saturday in Wailuku, and the 6-year state title reign for Iulani ended at the hands of number 3 Kauai 28-7, leaving the OIA and KIF champs to go after what would be both schools' first state tournament crown. Now I want to welcome to the show Cover 2 analyst, former Kahuku running back and Punahou running backs coach Brian Tate. And coach, dust has settled. Title games are set. When you look at Kahuku, Iulani obviously out, meaning for the first time in 3 seasons, a new state champ will be crowned. We'll get to the matchup shortly, but looking at the Final Four teams alive, how pumped are you for title night in the 808?
Well, I don't know about anybody else, but I'm going to be there when the gates open. I'm going to set up my tent, get the tailgate going. And this is an exciting time to watch two sophomore sensations go at it for Division I. And then also watch Kaiser take on another behemoth from Kauai.
Oh, absolutely. Fantastic season thus far. We don't expect anything less than that on Championship Saturday. With that being said, let's get this show started with the marquee matchup. And of course, we start with the Division I title game. And you talk about coming full circle. Back on August 15th, Punahou kicked off their season with a 24-14 win over Mililani at John Kawinana Stadium, jumpstarting a 10-0 run to their third straight state title game appearance. All season long, quarterback Tui Tui Leta has added to his legend, posting 2,300-plus yards with 25 touchdowns to just 4 interceptions. Sprinkle in the likes of Kanavai Noah and Wayne Taulapapa on offense to go with a dominant D led by Canton Kaumatule leaves the Buffs Nation confident they can avenge 2 straight title game losses to Kahuku. But on the other sideline, some young and restless Trojans. Running back Vavai Malapiai's 1,317 yards is the most ever gained by a sophomore in the state title era. And his wingman, Mackenzie Milton, also a sophomore, is just 1 yard shy of 1,500 to go with 19 total scores. Both teams, winners of 10 straight, setting up a classic clash of the Titans.
We just want to finish. You know, we're going to finish strong every time we practice, every time, every play, every opportunity. So that's kind of built into our program, and that's our word for the year, is we want to finish strong and finish well and hopefully finish on top.
We play for much greater purposes other than ourselves and our community, but we represent the underdog, and, you know, like every underdog, we're going to bring it. I promise you that we'll bring it on Saturday.
This is big for us. This is like redemption for us. I mean, we got to come out and prove to Hawaii what we can do. I mean, they're a good team, solid offensively and defensively, just like us. Should be a good game.
Punahou is a great team. We have a lot of respect for them. It's going to be a good fight. We don't put in work for nothing. All work, hard work pays off, so here it is.
So here's a look at the tail of the tape, so to speak, where the Buffs rank higher in nearly every category. This one was a slugfest in week number 1, and according to many across the state, it's set up to be another heavyweight showdown.
Like everybody else, I'm excited. I mean, it's a great game. You know, great matchup. I think, you know, 2 very talented teams. You know, it's a good matchup. It's a good matchup. I think... Yeah, to me, it's a toss-up.
Well, I think Mililani is going to try to establish a running game. You know, they have a great running back in Malapiai, but they also have a receiving corner, a young quarterback who's developed tremendously throughout this past season. So I think they've got to be dynamic with that. And then, of course, defensively, they have to find a way to stop Punahou, not just their passing attack with Tui Leta and Kanavai Noah, But shucks, they have a great running attack led by the horses up front.
I think it's going to come down to possessions. So Mililani's possessions has to count. And everybody knows turnovers, turn the ball over to a team like Punahou. That's just giving them more firepower for them to seal the deal for them. And I think it's vice versa for Punahou as well. I think it's going to be one of the best state championships in a while.
All right, Coach, we've heard from the teams. We've heard about the matchups. Let's take a look at things in a historical view. Punahou quarterback Tui Tuileta has been phenomenal in his career. Over 6,000 yards passing, 73 touchdowns, 3 ILH titles. When it's all said and done, are we looking at one of the great quarterbacks in Hawaii prep football history? And what would a state title win on Saturday night do for his legacy?
Absolutely. I think you can already chalk his name up to the greatest, like Timmy Chang and everybody else that's really done well. But to win the state championship after being a starting quarterback for 3 straight years and going to the big dance all 3 years, this would be a perfect cap to a stellar high school career.
And you look at a guy like Tui Tuileta, we talked about it so many times throughout the running of this show, his poise at quarterback. How special is that?
I've been on the sideline with this young man, and he does not get rattled. I mean, if he does, you can't see it, and it's hard for us to tell from the sideline. So he's a very poised young man, very patient, and very courageous because he can stay in that pocket.
Now, as Mililani goes, sophomore at QB, sophomore at running back, young head coach with fresh looks on offense and defense, do you get the sense that this could be the beginning of something very, very special in Central Oahu?
I think so. It's showing all the signs of a rich tradition about to just kind of bloom, and there might just be a new big kid on the block.
And speaking of big, this offensive line, I think, sometimes gets overlooked. You've seen these guys play. You've looked at them very closely. How special is that unit?
I've always been a fan of that Mililani front 5. I really felt that they allowed Malepe'ai to be the dynamic runner that he is. I mean, they can move mountains. And we've seen it against Farrington, against Kohuku. Those are mountains in the OIA.
This one could be epic. Again, the perfect finish to the Tuileta era at Punahou. Or perhaps the rise of the Trojans. Kickoff on Saturday night on Hawaiian Airlines Field at Aloha Stadium, set for 7 p.m. And to avoid crazy long lines at the box office, pre-sale tickets are available at all First Hawaiian Bank locations on Oahu and Lihue. Time to take a quick timeout. When we come back from this short break, we check out Division II, where Kaiser and Kauai are looking to make history. You're watching Cover 2. Welcome back to Cover 2, Hawaii High School Football Weekly. We're in Division 2. The third-seeded KIF champs of Kauai will take their perfect record to the state title game against the fourth-seeded OIA champions of Kaiser, who have won 12 straight games. Now, both were impressive in their semifinal wins. Red Raiders eliminated the 6-time defending state champs of Iolani, led behind the beef. Huge on the offensive and defensive lines, Kauai held the Raiders to 160 yards of offense, with running back Reggie McFadden going for 135 yards and a score. Now for the Cougars, it was all about persistence. Claiming all season long that they're the most conditioned team in the state, Kaiser backed it up, pouncing on a legendary Lahaina Luna team in the second half, with the Iron Man tandem of Thomas Buttonball Leong and Fito Fisiahi stealing the show on offense, defense, and special teams. Both squads are fast, they have the size, and carry a big chip on their shoulders.
You know, it's huge for these guys. They work so hard, and we got a chance to do something special this year. You know, this is for Kauai in general. You know, we went kind of under the radar the whole year, and that's how we like it. And it gives us the motivation and got us to this spot right now.
When people continue to think that you're the underdog, we can use that as motivation for our players. But our biggest job, I think, taking over this job, was convincing that these guys that they were good enough to win and that they should win.
You know, we're fast. we get to the football, and they play hard. That's all I ask these guys to do every day is play hard, and I think we'll be all right come Saturday.
When you look at Kauai on tape and you see that they beat a very physical Pearl City team that gave us some problems, they beat a very cerebral team, Iolani, that has been there and done that for the past 6 years. So this is a good football team, and I think they probably have a chip on their shoulder being seeded third. So it's going to be a great football game.
Now, if this game was played on paper, it'd be the greatest game of all time, as both bring crazy good units to Halaba. And according to experts, these numbers do not lie.
Well, when you look at Kauai, and that's most fresh in my memory, is they're a blue-collar football program, man. Offensively, they're big up front. You know, they come right at you. Don't let that four-receiver set fool you that they're going to throw the ball. Their main thing is to run the ball, and they do a good job coming off the ball.
The strength for Kaiser is the fact that they have motivation on their side, wanting to move up to Division One and not getting the opportunity to do so. They were highly motivated going into this year and just trying to make a statement across the state.
For Kauai, the key will be to avoid the big plays the Cougars are always capable of and try to find a way to hold them at bay for an entire game, which the Lunas learned was much easier said than done.
They're back-to-back Kauai champions. They're undefeated, and they're playing with a lot of confidence right now. Kaiser, on the other hand, is the same thing. You know, their last loss was to Campbell in the preseason, who was a Division I power. I think if you're a football fan, you can't ask for more.
Coach Tangon hitting it right on the head. Want to welcome back Cover 2 analyst Brian Teo. And Coach, you've been a huge fan of Division II all season long. Cover 2 Power Poll has had Kauai in at number 3 all year long. Obviously, voters were noticing. But seeing them these last 2 weeks, do you think that maybe that this team could have been overlooked, even though being given the respect of the number 3 team all season long? I mean, this team is big, they're fast, they're strong, they're physical, they have it all.
I think when you look historically in the Division II championship game, Kauai was very seldomly, if ever, in the picture. And I think to some degree the teams here on Oahu and even on the neighbor islands kind of took them for granted. And I think they've demonstrated that they deserve to be here, that they are going to give their best effort. And I'm pretty sure this is going to be slugfest number 2.
And I think no one doubted Kauai's skill positions, guys like Reggie McFadden, the Bukowskis. But when you look at those lines, how impressed were you with the lines, the size of that?
Hey, you're always good. You're always happy when you get to see line that can move mountains. And like the Mililani group, this group of Red Raiders can really move mountains.
Now, last week, Kanoa, he spoke with Coach Cal Lee. Kanoa made a reference that it seems everything Coach Cal touches turns to gold. When you look at Rich Miano, don't you find it hard to argue that he also, I mean, this guy's got the Midas touch, whether it be high school, college, NFL, coming back to coach at the University of Hawaii, Kaiser Cougars. I mean, this guy has done some phenomenal things here in this state.
Absolutely. I think you're going to see his name right next to the likes of Coach Cal Lee in a couple of years, because when you have an opportunity to play throughout all the levels in Hawaii and then go to college and then actually go to the NFL and then bring your college expertise back to the high school level, that's special. And not very many people would do that, but it's nice to see him there, and how his team is doing is just a reflection of that.
A man that exudes confidence, and his kids have taken to it, no doubt. Much like the Division I title game, this one sets up to be a thriller. Tommy John Cox, perfect thus far in his first season. Rich Miano, 19-4 in his second year. Kickoff set for 4 p.m. And again, to avoid those crazy lines at the box office at Aloha Stadium, pre-sale tickets are available at all First Hawaiian Bank locations on Oahu and Lihue. Well, it's halftime here on Cover 2. When we come back, we bust out the red carpet. Our boy Sam Spangler gets his Ryan Seacrest on. He's giving out some chrome domes.
Man, Rob, I'm sweating the paparazzi on Pete Coy. The ballots are sealed. Who'll take home the chrome? Stay tuned. You're watching Cover 2.
Welcome back to Cover 2, Hawaii High School Football Weekly. Now, over the last 3-plus months, we've had the privilege to feature amazing teams, incredible games, and unforgettable student-athletes. And as much as we'd like to hand out accolades to every single one of the varsity football players in the state, only 4 will take home honors in the inaugural Cover 2 Awards. Sam Spangler went on campus to catch up with the winners.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Over a 10-day period, 30-plus thousand ballots were submitted at KHON2.com to go with votes from our panel of experts. The people have spoken, and four stand alone. Let's take a trip on campus and onto the red carpet, where we introduce you to the finalists for Offensive and Defensive Players of the Year. We start in Division II on offense. Noah Brum, quarterback, Kalani. Makoa Faliki-Tonga, quarterback, Lahaina Luna. Bobby Lum, running back, Hawaii Prep. Thomas Leong, running back, Kaiser. Chase Takaki, wide receiver, Konawaena. And the Chrome Dome goes to Bobby Lum, accepting the award in Bobby's absence is Kamakani head coach Jordan Hayslip.
Yeah, Bobby had an excellent year for us, both on and off the field, you know what I mean? Off the field, he's our team leader. And it's especially awesome that it is Bobby, just because he's so humble. To have a kid like that recognized and to have it at our, you know, small school here on the Big Island is a great honor for us.
Sticking with Division II, your finalists on defense. Hercules Mata'afa, defensive lineman, Lahaina Luna. Makoa Chapa, linebacker, Konawaena. Bito Fisiahi, linebacker, Kaiser. Mark Ma, D-line, Iolani. Blake Cooper, defensive back, Pearl City. Your winner, the Greek god of the Lunas himself, Hercules Mata'afa.
I want to say thanks to the Hawaii, state of Hawaii. They've been on my back and pushing me from the beginning. Like Doris Sullivan, she was helping me get recruited and put a great community behind the Luna.
We stick with defense, but move up to Division I. Your finalists are Kalen Scott Holt, DN, Kamehameha Kapalama, EC Holani, D-line, Hilo, Micah Parrish, linebacker, Kapole, Kingston Fernandez, defensive line, Kapole, Kaili'i Padelo, defensive line, Mililani. The Chrome Dome goes home with the sack man from Central Oahu, K.K. Padelo.
It means everything. It's my senior year. I'd like to thank everybody that voted for me. And I'm very humbled that people would vote for probably the shortest D lineman in the state, but I just like to show up on the field.
And finally, to round out our show, we give you the offensive finalists from D1. Vavai Malepeai, running back, Mililani. Kainoa Simao, running back, Kamehameha Kapalama. Larry Tuituileta, quarterback, Punahou. Devin Stubblefield, wide receiver, St. Louis. Isaac Kerr, quarterback, Campbell. Soon to be hitting your television screens from the University of Hawaii at Manoa, Tuituileta.
That's a really good honor. I mean, I never thought that that many people would actually vote, but I'm really thankful, and I just want to thank everybody that voted, and I mean, I couldn't do it without my teammates. Yeah, I just want to thank them and thank everyone else that helped me get here.
And that concludes our show, folks. Until next season from the Cover 2 Awards, I'm Sam Spangler.
Thanks a lot, Bradley Cooper. Oh, sorry, I mean Sam Spangler. Congrats to all the finalists. Big ups to the winners, and be sure to swing by KHON2.com to see who won the Iron Man Award as the state's best two-way stud. But we still got one more Chrome Dome to give out tonight. When we come back, Kanoa Leahy goes one-on-one with the Coach of the Year. These are your finalists. You're watching Cover 2.
Hey, welcome back to Cover 2, everybody. Special edition of Leahy's Locker Room. We're here at Mililani High School, yes, to honor the Cover 2 Coach of the Year. And it is Rod York, head coach for the Mililani Trojans. And we got this nifty little helmet right there to commemorate your award. It's I don't know if it's going to fit. How cool of a year has this been for you and the Trojans?
It's been an awesome year for our kids and our faculty and our community. And all of Mililani is proud of our team and, you know, our kids is playing on a different level, and you know, hopefully we can continue that into Saturday's game against Punahou.
You know, it was interesting because we saw in some of the interviews earlier in the week, you got a little emotional talking about this opportunity for this team. Why? Why do you have those kinds of emotions going through you?
Well, I mean, it's a first for us, and it's been fun, and it's exciting, and yeah, it's definitely has gone throughout our community and our school, and everybody's just proud of this team.
You know, we're here on the campus. There's a buzz around here. How do you perceive what's going on here at Mililani?
Well, I mean, you know, just, you know, dealing with our parents, it's been a whole lot more positive this year. Yeah, we're going to edit that one.
We're not going to get into it because we don't necessarily have the time to break down this matchup against Punahou, but when you think about Punahou and Punahou football, what comes to mind?
You know, they're big, they're fast, they're loaded, they're reloaded. They got great coaching. You know, they're excellent. They perform well. And it's going to be a tough task. But like I said, you know, we're up for a challenge, and we're ready for a match come Saturday night.
We're hoping for a little more hardware to go along with the Cover 2 Coach of the Year helmet.
Well, you know, I mean, it's an individual award, but definitely it's the ultimate team sport. And, you know, the ultimate goal would be to win that championship, and we're going to do everything we can to win it on Saturday.
It's going to be a fun one, that's for sure. Mililani Trojans head coach Rod York, congratulations. Well-deserved Cover 2 Coach of the Year. Let's send it back to the studio.
Thanks a lot, Kanoa. Mahalo for all your great work this season. All right, fellas, this is it. Juice time for the final time. Who you got, Coach?
I'm going to give my juice away to Doris Sullivan with Pacific Islands Athletic Alliance. This is for you, sister, all the work you do for all the athletes in Hawaii.
Sam
and
Spangler.
I got Mr. DeMello for putting the show together every week. Spends two nights a week sleeping at the office so he can put this thing together. Here's to you, Rob.
You already got the job, Sam. You don't have to worry about it. But much mahalo for that. I'm giving mine out to the Hawaii High School football community. Oahu, Maui, Big Island, Kauai, you guys have been fantastic. Mm-hmm. 37,000 people voting for the Cover 2 Awards. You guys have accepted us in, and we can't thank you more enough than that. Well, that does it for us. We got 40 tickets to the state championship doubleheader to give away. I got 20. Sam got 20 to qualify. Let us know on Twitter who you got this weekend. Use the hashtag Cover2 and give us a follow. We'll DM the winners later tonight. For Kanoa Leahy, Sam Spangler, Brian Te'o, on our entire Cover2 family, thanks for watching, everybody. Aloha.